Hey, Crazeron here, and this is XCOM 2. We're back. Last time I did a video, it was the Friday morning that the game came out, and it was after a shift, so it was a really short session. But now, I'm back. And what's so different? Well, I discovered, it's not really a big discovery. I mean, the internet's been talking about it, and I think Free Access also mentioned it, but all the config files, the INI files, that kind of stuff, are easily accessible and readily editable. And you can pretty much make the game exactly the way you want it. You can make it easier, you can make it harder, you can make your own little long war mod. And I've literally spent hours upon hours upon hours these last couple days since that video, tweaking, playing for a bit, trying to see how far along some tweaks go. Like, there are some tweaks that you think are good, but they don't manifest themselves until into a decent playing experience until mid-game or even late-game. But I think I've figured out a decent balance right now. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to start all the way from the beginning. I do have a campaign that's a little bit after in a spot. Like, it's a placement in the story is a little bit after the last video. But along with that, we have a whole cast of characters that I also decided to add on. So, you know, I thought it would be funny, be interesting to have me and my friends on here. And I did modify the squad limit to 6, like Long War. So there will be 6 people total running around, along with upgradable to 2 more. So it will be 8. So we got me being the Ranger, because most video games, I always rush forward. If it's Borderlands, if it's Call of Duty, whatever it is, I'm going to keep running ahead. And so the Assault class is no more, so I use the Ranger class. Then I got Ryan, good old drunk sniper. Always a sniper, always has been, always will be, till the end. So gave him a sniper rifle, and he has a thing for fedoras. I think he would argue to give him the really kick-ass looking hoods, but I'm more for keeping him with the hoodie. Where is it? Or sorry, the fedora. Look, see, we got the recon hood. We also got some of the Resistance Warrior Pack DLC, like a really dirty Ezio hood or something. Then we got John. I got him as a medic, as a support class, because in Battlefield, especially in Battlefield 3 and the early days of Battlefield 4, he would just shadow me around as I ran around getting my ass kicked, and he would just heal me. Like, I think most of his points sometimes when we traveled together was him healing me or finishing my kills. So then we got Paige. Got him a grenade launcher. He's the grenadier, because he's like the engineer in Battlefield Friends. If it's remotely overpowered, he might spam it. And with my tweaks to the game that I've done so far, the grenade launcher is pretty potent, but I've made my tweaks here and there. Then Josh. He's more of a bow and arrow kind of guy, but he's still a decent shot as well. So I got 2 snipers pretty much. And the amazing Sarah White. She's not a real person. It is a reference to my first XCOM playthrough that I did a recording on. She is amazing. She is, I don't know how to explain it. There is also video evidence that I've put her in front of people with a shotgun to get an advantage. She will proceed to miss that shot, and then she will get, or the enemies will attempt to gangbang her while she's surrounded by about 3 or 4 enemies. And there has been at least 5 different times that they did not hit her, and they were within about 3 tiles of her. She is a legend, and she's the only one I really remember out of that that play series. I might rewatch some of it, skim it, and see if there's anybody else notable to bring back on here. But for now, I have my full roster of 6. And here I am right here. So we're going to drop right in, and we'll play it through. Do a couple matches here and there, and we'll see how they turn out, if they'll live or not. These 6 people are the only people I have present on staff. Like, the barracks only has the 6. I don't have any more, and I've been working on these folks. So we're going to jump right in. I think we got grill ops going on. Recover intel from setting facility. For sector 15, all right, let's jump right in. And so I've tweaked a lot of things. If you can't tell, I made the avatar project take longer to fill out. I have, what else did I do? Oh, I also got the mods, the day one mods that FreeAxis recruited the developers from the Long War mod. Because there are a couple day one mods that they went ahead and built up. So it's the submachine gun mod, the leadership mod, and I think that's it. I guess you could consider my stuff mods, like my I&I tweaks, but I wouldn't. So see, there's a sub right there. I also tweaked its damage. I tweaked everything's damages, including the mods. I didn't use the Steam Workshop. I used the Nexus, so I can have easy access to the configs to bring it in line with the weapons. So I doubled all of our health. I doubled everybody's health, enemies and friendlies. I doubled all the damage. I tweaked some of the perks. Actually, here, let's just launch. I can talk later. But I tweaked some of the perks. I made the Ranger Sword a little more potent, only because if you're going to expose yourself, you might as well make it worth it. But now I fear I might be past the point of no return on how a little overpowered it is. So we gotta neutralize all targets and recover. Okay, we gotta recover something from the Advent. Oh, that ship just went through the buildings. That's fine. But I'm not far enough in the story yet to have armors and stuff. So here we are. Look at that health. The only reason why I added so much health was because I wanted granularity. I didn't want something so simple as a difference between one or two blocks. I wanted it all the way, like, there can be a difference between someone having one health and actually making a difference. Like, if you don't fully kill someone all the way, it shouldn't be just a matter of taking one block off. It should be a matter of taking a bunch off. So, everyone's pretty ranked up. I'm going to keep me and Sarah together. Where is she? Me and Sarah are going to travel together. I also tweaked the enemy's armor values. Pretty much all of the Advent soldiers, they're wearing body armor. Or at least what appears to be body armor. So I decided I should actually give them armor. So most of them have, or they all have, 100% chance of having at least one block of armor. Let's see. I don't know where to move John here. Let's just keep him out of sight. Go, go, go. So we have a lot of health, but we don't have armor yet. I also got the Advanced Warfare Center, and so some of these people have innate abilities, some of my troops. Okay, so they're wandering over that way. But yeah, I upgrade. I made the sniper rifle be able to pierce but not shred armor. I made it so that assault rifles can be carried by any class. So when you combine that with the marksman, with the sharpshooter, you can have more flexible units. Like, for example, Josh and Ryan right here. Ryan is right there, and then Josh is right there. Josh and Ryan are both sharpshooters. Sharpshooters have an innate accuracy bonus. Ryan has a sniper rifle. He can't shoot his rifle. He can't move and shoot in the same turn. Josh can, but Ryan has a bigger range. And so they have the same bonuses, but different weapon applications. So it's actually a really nice form of flexibility. Hopefully I don't get John killed. I realize there might be more people around here.
I have eyes on the enemy.
Yep. I also doubled the spawn rates. That is actually very daunting. That is very scary looking. I doubled the spawn rates because I really wanted to just kind of lengthen battles. Not like Long War where they lengthen the entire campaign. I wanted to lengthen individual missions. And so that's why I gave everyone more health, kind of deal. Everyone's concealed. Yeah, John has an innate ability that allows him to overwatch while... if both of his moves are overwatch moves. or sorry, both if both of his moves aren't an attacking move, or both of his actions aren't attacking actions, then he gets an automatic Overwatch. That's what I'm trying to say. I don't know why that Stun Lancer is just wall walking. Okay, so the objective is over there. Oh my god, this is just so juicy right here. Can Paige reach that? No, he cannot. Where can I push Paige? Like, I want to just wipe all of these guys out. Like, I can't even reach them. Here, what we can do is me and Sarah can flank. Hopefully, I don't reveal too many more enemies, because once you start revealing too many enemies with the way I redistributed the spawn rates, it becomes really overbearing, because the moment you trigger a reveal, everyone starts collapsing on your position, and it just becomes that much harder. Let's see, I want to keep Paige in cover. I want to keep Josh and Ryan up top, because that sightline is really important. I don't want John to be exposed too much. I don't want him to be pincered between these two teams. I might back him up a bit. I didn't fix the accuracy at range, but I did tweak a couple things. So there's only one place I can move him comfortably, is right there. All right, so Paige, I will have him kind of skirt around here as well. Hopefully the car doesn't blow up anytime too soon. Okay, let's hope the enemies don't spot anyone yet. Nope, they might see Paige. Oh, Lord. Yep. Paige is spotted. Everyone's going to move into cover. Reaction fire. Oh, that reaction fire. Is Paige still alive? Okay, they missed. Target neutralized. Damn, I was trying to get Paige into position to grenade these guys. Oh, and they're all over the map. They spotted Sarah. That is so not cool. And now it's all gone to hell. But thankfully, it's still my move. So, let's thin the herd. So, it's a little laggy. I got this perk called Reaper. It's only available for a Colonel Ranger. High-level Ranger. It's a chain melee attack. Quietly. So now, I can reveal myself, but I can smack these people around. So I can snag that Stun Lancer, hit that Trooper, actually, and finish at that Viper. Or I can just redistribute everything. Okay, so first off, Paige got lucky. I'm gonna say that right now. I'm going to have to decide what I'm gonna do with Paige, though. I could open up the wall a little bit right here. Yeah, I'll open up the corner. Paige is just awesome artillery right now. A boom, 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 boom. Well, damn. Paige reduced the amount of people I have to go apeshit ham on. So now we can do slash. So I'm going to go hit this guy. Or wait, who should I hit first? I want to chain these, because the only downside is it nerfs your damage little by little by 1 point. So let's hit this guy, since he has the most health. I mean, I can hit the Viper at any time. They spawned me. So there's the objective. Yeah, I don't care. I got 5 turns to grab it. Hatha! Then I'm not going to cut him because he has way low health. I can use another unit on him. Then go for the slash! Haha! Then I can pick up that item. Every kill I make, I go down. My weapon damage goes down by, I think, 1. That's a value I can't change. That's a hard-coded value. And then next enemy is you. And I have a perk that allows me to... oh, there's more enemies. I have a perk that allows me to go back into concealment. Okay, so they move forward. Can I actually reach any of them? No, I cannot. I'm flanked. I'm flanked, so I can't go back into conceal. But I can't shoot. But I'm exposed. Yeah, I'll back off. I'll back off into here, which is a high cover on two sides, or high cover and medium color cover. Then I'm going to move John to the spark bench. Moving to designated position. I can't conceal her because she's flanked. What is her reach? She can only reach that. Oh, she can reach that Viper as well. Okay, so what we're going to do is I need Ryan to completely kill that. Oh, I can't have Ryan kill that guy. Shit. Here, can we let's double it up. Oh wait, shit, I forgot. I purposely spec'd the handguns to not do a lot of penetration damage. Or sorry, the handguns do not penetrate at all. Is Ryan the only... Yeah, so Ryan and John. So John needs to... Actually, I can have Ryan pick off the Viper, and I can have John pick off the... pick off that guy. Or no, John can't move. Shit. So I'll move Ryan. Ryan has no cover. I'll move him down here. And hopefully, since I have no guarantee of completing it in one hit, I'll use both my light. Oh shit. He just ate that. Hard target, minimal damage. Yeah, it's a hardened target. Okay, so one of these two guys are getting shot. This was poorly executed. I should have killed him first. But John's gonna kill this Viper. Wow, he missed. I was going to kill that Viper and then cloak her and then move her forward. But she can't because she is flanked. She's flanked on two sides, actually. So, I'm trusting you. Oh, shit. I was trying to move her into a better position, but yeah, I still can't hide. Can I hit? Can I actually hit that Viper from here? And I did. I definitely got that one. All right, so we'll see what happens now. Oh, yeah, she can move again. So what I'm going to do is probably try and move her up top in a position where the enemies have a hard time to hit her. Then I'm going to cloak her, I'll cloak me, and then I'll push onto these two guys. I'm more worried about what that mech is going to do to my folks over here. Who's he going to choose? Well, he has Ryan flanked. What the hell? He missed Ryan but hit Paige. That is, don't know how I feel about that. Oh. Taking fire over here. I have the untouchable perk too, which means that any hits after I commit a kill as a ranger, miss. He acted like he broke a window. Or did I change it to two? I thought I set it to one attack. Or maybe it was two. See, now this one should have a chance of hitting me. That one's just a normal miss. Okay. That was close. So those are only three enemies spotted, right? Fire's getting close here. Fire's spreading. Paige is under critical condition, but he got hit with a critical, but he's still fine. Ryan is built as a marksman who has a lot of damage on elevated stuff. Josh is designed for more close quarters. So the mech is dead. Running. I'll push Ryan up so he can sit on the rooftop.
Seems doable. Moving out.
Let's see what she's got. I can thwack the stun lancer. Okay, so who has shots first off? Paige can't hit nothing. I think John can hit the Viper. I want the Viper to be hit. Damn it. Only did half damage. So that means I need to be on Overwatch. They know she's here, so what I need to do is... I'm not going to cut these guys just yet. I was going to slash these guys, but... It's kind of a no-go. So let's push over here. I'm going to disappear as well. Oh wait, I can't conceal because I'm still flanked. Oh wait, there we go. Wow, it takes a long time for it to load. Let's see. Can I not move? Oh, I can. Okay, so I can ninja my way out of this. Conceal normally only has one use, but I upped it just so I can play Ranger, a more effective Ranger stealth, because I like to... Holy shit! I like to play the Ranger as kind of a ninja that kind of wanders around the map. I use them as flankers, stealth flankers. Oh look, Paige's Overwatch actually spot the guy.
Impressed yet?
I could say a little bit. Okay, so the container's gonna detonate soon. Paige can't have a good day, can he?
Incoming over here. Menace 1-5, the clock is ticking.
Okay, so the clock is ticking. I got 3 moves left.
Get to the vault and disarm it before we run out of time.
These maps are quite big. Oh shit. Compared to the original XCOM. Alright, let's position everyone. Let's position everyone to be in a good position. Or to be a little bit beneficial for the folks that are planning to arrive there. I think I want to keep Josh up here because he can still see some of these people. Like, look at that. He has 32 and a 40 or 36.
Got it covered.
I'll push him to that side. Let's put... I don't know if I want to put John that close to the drop zone.
Roger that.
I don't have run and gun. Can I kill him in one hit? Oh, and I also go into cover on the statue. It's kind of a waste to use cloaking for that just one move, but it does put me in a better position because they don't see me. And pick up the attachment, damn it. The game's oddly slow at times. Illyrium core.
Target asset recovered.
And last but not least, we got this guy who I can't really see. Yep, so I'll put Paige over here. Can I hack someone? Oh cool, I can hack that chest without moving.
Bypassing security.
Why didn't I do that? I guess I have to be within range, actually. Yeah, John's a computer science major, so that's why I made him the hacker as well. He's also a very good medic in a video game that has heals. There you go. Because Bad Company 2, Battlefield 3, Battlefield 4, John's a guy who always got your back. All right, so can I do another move, or... I want to keep her in the quiet area, like stealthy and hidden. But I don't think I can. Okay, so if I bust the glass, he's gonna notice. But I'm gonna pop him with the shotgun. So.
I guess that'll be okay. Position compromised.
At the very least, I can use the cloak to get in a better position. So. Oh yeah, she has holo targeting, doesn't she? Yeah, she had one of those things from the Advanced Warfare Center that allowed her to get a random attribute.
Okay,
I'm like, why does a Ranger have holo targeting? All right, so the folks are gonna land. I'm not under Overwatch. Thankfully, I'm not taken cover by that car anymore, which had little to no indication of detonating. Oh, look, the T-pose, Advent soldiers. It's because the reason why there's some T-pose guys is because since I doubled the spawn rate and the appearance rate, those guys aren't animated to jump out of the dropship. They just spawn them there. The game does anyway. So I'm actually unable to witness their movement. That's not good. I don't even know how many dropped. Okay, so they're all there. Paige is in a good spot. John is in a pretty awful spot. I can put him right here. I also tweaked how far the enemies prefer to be to you. So I have the officers, the captains, prefer to be far away, while the normal troopers I have out front. Let's see, where can I put Josh? I could probably flank these two guys. John is in a really bad spot. Can I even get him elevated? I could keep him elevated. Ryan, I wish I had the time. I would have given him a kill zone. Every time these guys drop, he would just pop them. So who I got? 96, 96, 70, 87. Let's see, where is Josh? Josh has a 100, a 52, 84, 79. How about me? She can reach that guy. Damn. These Rangers have quite a reach. Oh, cool. I have Reaper. Reaper takes 3 cooldown. But, it appears that... Oh, yeah. Sweet. It appears that 3 moves have passed. This might be a little OP. I might have to nerf it. But there's no way I can nerf it, really. Or without nerfing the actual sword. Because I did make the sword more powerful in the argument that, you know... See, I just made myself exposed. Let's see. Is there anyone else? There's only 2 people I can thwack. This guy's the hardest to hit for everyone. It could be worse, though. I mean, there was a playthrough I was testing where Ryan with with Killzone, he was able to just murder anyone that wandered in his range. Because I did add 1 extra shot per weapon, like the magazines. And so with Killzone, anyone that wanders into that radius or that range will automatically fire at whatever enemy's in there. And so I've had one where Ryan just killed every single person that wandered into it. Like, if I did this, the kill zone, and I did this right here, if those guys move at all, they would get shot by Ryan. This guy over here has the most health and is the farthest from me. He's dead. Which is why people like Ryan and even Paige level up quickly in my playtest, because Paige has a grenade launcher. Even though I have a sword, which is pretty powerful, in most cases, if I'm used as a scout, I can't get close enough to people without getting severely injured. And my guy ends up a lot of downtime, or any ranger for that matter, ends up with a lot of downtime in the med bay, because, you know, they're out in the front all the time. See, so where is Paige? Can Paige not shoot? I guess he can't hit that guy. No kill like overkill. Oh, that guy's on the other side of the... Fire in the hole. That was a mistake on my behalf. This guy's gonna have a bad day. And there you go.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.